In part 5 of my video series on converting a Prusa Mark IV into a granule printer, I once again had to make some changes to the core component, the extruder. I now have reached version 5.4 in my numbering scheme. As you can see, the printer is already working very well, but there's still a bit of fine-tuning to do. In the previous video I mentioned that the planetary gear was too weak and therefore had to be replaced with a more sturdy version. Since this new gearbox is a little larger, a few 3D printed parts had to be modified. Of course I printed the new parts with the previous version of the extruder. For the first time I printed PETG. Among other parts, the stepper mount is made of this more temperature resistant material, the print of which can be seen here. The component that I call powder chamber was also revised. This is also made of PETG. This material is printed at higher temperatures than PLA so that water cooling and hot end are operating at a higher limit. Even at a temperature of 265 degrees Celsius in continuous operation, the extruder worked without any problems. Normally PETG is not processed at such high temperatures, but I just wanted to test whether the extruder can do that. The printing of the powder chamber took 2.5 hours. The new gearbox has a hole with an M3 thread on the output shaft. I gradually drilled this out to a diameter of 3.2 mm so that the shaft of the 4.5 mm wood screw would fit in. A 3 mm hole across the shaft axis is used to fix the auger. The screw shaft is slightly ground flat at the point of the hole. An M10 nut with an M3 thread on one side is used to clamp the wood screw with an M3 screw. This new coupling is stiffer, the wood screw is better centered and this type of attachment also allows the auger screw to be replaced quickly. In the previous video I already mentioned that the wood screw can be seen as a consumable. It costs next to nothing. A metal strip soldered to the M10 nut serves as a stirrer for the powder to be printed. The new extruder tube has a slightly larger inner diameter of 7 mm. Together with a stiffer coupling for the auger, the wood screw should no longer scrape the inside wall, at least I haven't heard any such noises so far. I also mentioned in the previous video that the storage container will no longer be attached to the Z-axis. The separate tower now required is composed of 90 cm long square aluminum bars with 3D printed parts made of recycled PLA. The total height of the printer has therefore increased to 107 cm. The tower is screwed to a base plate, same as the Prusa. The subframe on the Z-axis is no longer required. The sensor which indicates whether new powder needs to trickle down from the storage container is now a commercially available light sensor that is installed outside the feeder tube. The front side of the powder chamber was also modified. The filling funnel through which the chamber can also be emptied was previously held in place with magnets, it is now a front door that is attached with a clamp. A pickle jar with a screw cap, which is also attached to the base plate, serves as reservoir for the cooling water. When it comes to firmware, I upgraded to version 6.1.4, which was the latest at the time of recording the video. The problem with the strange interpretation of the M906 command for the phase current is definitely better. But the measured value of 1.3 amps is slightly above the specification of 1 amp. Of the different NEMA 17 stepper motors I purchased, I have currently installed the variant with a maximum phase current of 1.5 amps and a step angle of 1.8 degrees. The gearbox and stepper motor weighed 517 grams compared to 501 grams for the old version. The printer now works as well as I imagined it would when the project was launched a few years ago as part of the Hackaday Prize. The Hackaday Prize motivated me several times to continue the project and in 2021 I was even able to win the 5th place with one of the prototypes. The prize money was quickly used up and development slowed again until contact was made with a generous sponsor for the project at the beginning of 2024. In the same year, development continued very quickly, which has now led to a device that is not yet perfect but absolutely practical. Buying filament is a thing of the past for me, reusing old prints is the cheapest raw material on the planet. But even if fresh pellets are used, it will be significantly cheaper and empty plastic spools will no longer end up in the landfills. So, mission accomplished, project finished? No, because this is a completely new type of FDM printing, which is why there's still a lot more of my knowledge to share, for example about the raw material and its preparation. There are also definitely more words to be said about the impact of the particle size distribution of the powder on the print quality. The machine parameters have not yet been optimized either, the print quality seen here is not the end of the story. Since the granule extruder also enables the printing of new materials, there is still plenty of research work to be done. The next printer waiting to be converted is the Retric V-Core 4. As always, the build instructions for extruder version 5.4 including the 3D files for converting a Prusa Mark IV are available on my website. I still have a lot of ideas in my head about this new printing technology and if you continue to help me finance the development work, I can publish the resulting inventions under a free license as I usually do. Many thanks to all the great people who have already sent me an Opel via the donate button on my website or in other ways. Thanks for watching and I'll be back.